So what we have in flowchart is we have boxes which represent the process, and we connect these boxes or processes with the help of arrow which tells the flow of the process. And we have decision boxes which tells that if something happens, then you do this. If something else happens, then you do that. We will look at an example of this on the next slide. But let's understand that why we need flowchart. We need flowcharts to understand the process flow and to see the interrelationship between processes. So this basically helps you in visualizing the process. So here on the right side is an example of a simple flowchart. So in a flowchart, you have start and end boxes. So this is my start box and this is my end box. So after starting, we do process number one, then we do process number two, and then after process number two, the item is inspected. So this is the decision box, which is in the diamond shape. And then in the inspection, when the item is accepted, it goes to process three. If the item is rejected, it goes back to process two. And once process three is complete, then this whole process ends. So this is a very simple flowchart. So here what we have used is we have just used four symbols. The symbol for starting and ending, the symbol for process, the symbol for decision, and the connectors to connect all these. So here on the left side, I have commonly used symbols in flowchart. We have talked about starting, ending, we have talked about process, we have talked about connectors which connect all these processes, and we have talked about decision box. So basically these four are very common symbols in a flowchart. But in addition to that, you can have symbols such as symbol for data, where your data is, your database is, your document, where you document something. This is for preparation and this symbol is for delay. But in majority of your flowcharts, you will be just using these four common symbols, which are start, end, process, connector, and decision. So this is one example of a flowchart. Another type of flowchart is swim lane flowchart. This is also called as cross-functional flowchart. So here what we have is, in addition to the flow of processes, here we have different lanes for different functions. So let's say here I have lane 1, lane 2, lane 3. And this is a blank flowchart. And in lane 1, let's say I have sales. In lane 2, let's say I have design. In lane 3, let's say I have production. Lane 4 is dispatch. Lane 5 is after sales, and so on. So what you can see on a swim lane flowchart is not just the flow of processes, but in addition to that, you can also see that who is responsible for this. So let's say this particular process, which is process number 1, is done by sales. Then sales gives some information to design. So this step number 2 is done by design. Then it comes back to sale. And then from here, it goes back to the production. And in production, there is a decision. If something happens, then you go this side. If something doesn't happen, you go back, and so on. So now just by visually looking at this, you not only understand the process, but you also understand the responsibilities, who are responsible for something. So on the previous slide, I have shown you a simple flowchart. Here I'm showing you swim lane flowchart. So if you want to make a flowchart, you can go to a site which is draw.io. And you can draw these flowcharts online. So just in case, if you want to make nice presentable flowcharts, go to this website, and without any registration, without any login, you can just start drawing flowchart, and then you can save your flowchart files, which you can use later on.